let's talk bath bombs, guys. I have challenged myself to a new hobby, and that is to make bath bombs. I don't really know why, but sometimes things just seem really cool to me and challenging, and I take on interesting new hobbies like knitting or body butters or, you know, just stuff that I think would be popular amongst friends and patrons alike. So I've decided to try to make bath bombs. So they're actually pretty complicated. I'm literally starting from scratch, and I thought, why not bring people along for the ride that are interested in this as well? To be brutally honest, I've never actually taken a bath with a real bath bomb before. So we're going to discover what bath bomb recipe is going to work, and perhaps some that maybe aren't going to work, because everything I've looked up is different. There are three basic ingredients in a bath bomb. There's baking soda, there's citric acid, which, you know, to me, I hear that and I go, really? Doesn't that just sound really enticing? You know, what we've got in your bath here is citric acid. Baking soda, citric acid, and Epsom salt. There's a bunch of different stuff that you can actually put into the bath bomb. So there's oils you can add, there's fragrances you can add. You know, I don't know what's with this fad of, you know, making your bath smell like a donut, but it's apparently very popular. So I'm going along the lines more of aromatherapy, because, and the only reason I'm doing this is aromatherapy has helped me out a lot. If you talked to me 2 years ago, I would have said aroma poopa therapy. Like, I did not believe it at all. I was not on the holistic bandwagon whatsoever. I would have told you, you know, okay, yeah, smells. That's gonna make you better. But I have experienced it for myself, and it does actually, as much as I hate admitting when stuff helps me, it helps me. Today, what I'm going to do is I'm going to make a very basic bath bomb with you guys. Okay? And since I don't have a recipe, like, down, what I'm going to do is, like, trial and error. So I'm gonna do a couple different recipes today. I'm going to do a very basic bath bomb with just citric acid, baking soda, and Epsom salt. Add some oils in there for skin softening purposes. Skin softening purposes. And also, I'm just gonna do this as a breathe bath bomb. So this is gonna be for opening up those sinuses and, you know, helping people breathe out their nose just a little bit better than an average day. You know, a little relax and breathe easy bath. Organs working better for you. Whatever you gotta think of. Okay, so I'm gonna do a very basic one without cornstarch and just very basic. I'm also gonna do a basic recipe with castile soap added to it. I'm gonna do basic with vegetable glycerin added to it. And then I'm also going to do the cornstarch recipe and also do one with castile and one with vegetable glycerin. And we're gonna see which variation works the best. So stick around to the end of the video. See what just a basic basic bath bomb looks like versus one with cornstarch. We're gonna figure out what's the difference here. It's gonna be an experiment. We are going to experiment today. We're going to figure out which one of these bath bombs is the perfect bath bomb. We're gonna figure that out. I'm the scientist today. Yesterday I was an accountant. Today I am a scientist. Stick around. Like, let's make some bath bombs, you guys. And okay, so we're here in scientist land. A land I don't often visit too often. Often's a fun word to say, often. Okay, so I've mixed up my, and this is my fun other angle camera. It's pretty awesome. Just for you guys. Just for you. So I've got my baking soda. I did a cup of baking soda, and I'm gonna do
a half a cup of citric acid. It's a fresh bag. We like it when they're fresh.
Okay. So does not hit your throat well. Feel so citric acidy. Okay, so I'm just doing my three basic ingredients. I got Epsom salt. Now Epsom salt is super exfoliating for skin, or so I've read. Okay, so those three basic ingredients are going in the base. And I'm gonna dump half of this into another bowl. So in this one, I'm going to add the cornstarch, and I'm just going to do like a half of a cup. I'll do about a tablespoon of each oil, and I'm just doing fractionated coconut oil and sunflower oil. A light oil is what you want, I guess. Stuff that'd be good for the skin.
So the other thing that I want to dabble with in the next bombs I make are adding a bath melt. So that's like just like cocoa butter or something like that hardened in the bath bomb itself. Super cool. I mean, come on.
I also want to add our scents in, and I think I'm just going to do a total of about 20 drops, so I think I'll do probably 10 eucalyptus. Well, yeah. 10 eucalyptus. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10.
It smells fresh in here, like a scientist's dream. I'm gonna do 5 tea tree. Tea tree's a super overpowering one.
2, 3, 4, 5. I'm gonna do 5 dream. 2, 3, 4, 5. Yeah, first off the bat here, I really wanted to like experiment with having like layers and having like the base be, you know, like eucalyptus, but then the inner part be geranium and tea tree. But I figured I just would hold off and not go too far, you know.
That smells delightful. I really wouldn't mind. Okay, so this is our plain. Baking soda, no cornstarch blend. And that scent is delightful. Delightful. It's just, I feel aromatic, like I could do anything right now. I could fly like Superman. This is what I mean, aromatherapy is just, it's a beautiful thing. Aromatherapy, beautiful. Okay, so I'm gonna make my regular one right off the bat. I'm gonna make a couple of bath bombs from that. So this is a isopropyl alcohol. 91%. So I'm gonna do 5 sprays. Mix it up. We'll see.
I just bought this spray bottle today, so we're just really going to see how Walmart has their scientific tools department. And I guess you're supposed to do it until it's the consistency of sand. Feels pretty sandy. But I sure don't know.
Let's just do like a few more spritz for some. That one smells like alcohol. That's for sure. I hope it doesn't take my lovely scent away. I hope the isopropyl alcohol doesn't steal the, because I'm like, that does not smell like a beautiful bath bomb. That smells like vodka. Straight up vodka. Straight vodka.
Smells like vodka. Okay, well, I feel like it's pretty mixed up, so
I feel drunk. I feel like I'm playing in the sand. what you got from them? Do you? I don't care.
Just feels like it's coming out like way. I don't know. Okay, so that's just our normie bath bomb. Let's do one with a teeny tiny bit of vegetable glycerin. That should be enough for one. Let's try a little bit of vegetable glycerin in this one. Like a little teeny tiny whiny bit. Triplet. Yeah, it feels like this is just, I'm not sure if these are supposed to be so easy to break apart, but oh well. There's our vegetable glycerin one. And then this one will be our plain castile soap one. Okay. Tiny bit of castile soap in that. This is exciting, isn't it? I mean, these are just supposed to be.
So I've got my three for the just basic mix, and we'll see what those look like. Now let's move on to our cornstarch mix.
Five sprays, my lovely booze smelling isopropyl alcohol, then, you know, trying to, I'll just keep them straight. So add a little vegetable glycerin to this guy. You need a bit of castile soap in.
We are all done making the bath bombs. We'll let them dry out and then we'll see what they look like.
Okay, so as promised, here we are again. This is going to be the first bath bomb we're going to do. This is just the baking soda and the Epsom salt and the cornstarch. So we'll see what it looks like, and I'm also going to time it and see how long it takes so we can figure out the differences between all of these bath bombs, these both bombs. Yes. Okay, so that was literally the baking soda, plain, no cornstarch added. It took 30 seconds for it to dissolve. Okay, so next we're gonna do an even smaller bath bomb than that one, but this one has got the vegetable glycerin in it. So we'll see what it does, what kind of difference it makes in the water. So let's put her in. Okay, so it looks like there was a little bit of soap in the vegetable glycerin one, but
What I'm noticing with the plain baking soda bath bombs is they dissolve super fast. So we'll do the final one, which is the one with castile soap. So stay tuned. Here's our final one with the castile soap. Let's see what it looks like. So again, a little bit of bubbles, but nothing too crazy. So let's move on to the ones with the cornstarch. So here is the bath bomb with just cornstarch. It doesn't have any vegetable glycerin or castile soap. It's just cornstarch added to the basic mix. So let's see what it looks like. So, the one with the cornstarch was actually a smaller bath bomb than the original baking soda one. It was like the medium size, and it was 35 seconds that it took for the even smaller bath bomb to dissolve. So I'm guessing that probably would take longer. So the cornstarch does make those bath bombs fizz out longer. So let's see what it looks like with vegetable glycerin in it. So we got a little bit of bubbles, definitely got a lot more scent, so it definitely is seeming like the ones with the cornstarch are also holding the scent a little bit better than the just basic blend. So let's see what castile soap looks like with cornstarch, and that'll be our last one. Oh man, after that last one with the vegetable glycerin, it smells like a French sauna on here. It smells just uplifting, and my nasal passages are clear like a scientist's would be. Okay, this one, you even noticed too that they are a little bit heftier with the cornstarch. Like, this definitely feels very solid. So let's see what the castile soap one looks like. So the water feels really, really nice to an extent. I don't think I like the sunflower oil. It's kind of greasy feeling. Although there is 6 bath bombs in here right now, so that could be a reason for that. But letting it just kind of dry naturally on my hand, it feels really soft. So it goes from greasy to soft, I guess. I don't know. But definitely very moisturizing. Feels really nice on the skin. So I think my favorite blend out of those was the cornstarch blend with the castile soap. That one seems like it's a good one. I'm sure the vegetable glycerin is probably better too. So that's our basic bath bomb biography number one. Stay tuned next time. I'm going to mess with embeds and lakes versus micas. So that's going to be our next journey along this ride, and see if I can sell these bad boys and or make an Etsy or Etsy. I don't know. Which one are you? Let's see if I can sell these bad boys, and you guys can join me for the ride. Thanks for watching. Make sure you subscribe and comment below if you have suggestions and or comments. I like that.